Did you know that when it first came out, Star Wars The Phantom Menace was compared to Citizen Kane? George Lucas really didn't like this because he thought that Citizen Kane wasn't good because the voices told him it wasn't. As a result, he paid off everyone to say the movie is bad, and this has continued to this day. Episode 1, the super relevant to the rest of the story, Menace. You may notice that I'm using Lego game footage. This is not so Disney won't claim this video, it's actually the version of the story with the best voice acting. This is Obi-Wan Kenobi. He's relevant. This is his supervisor Qui-Gon. He isn't. These two are on a space station because... I don't know, was I supposed to read that yellow shit? Then they left. Meet Jar Jar Binks, who's objectively the best character. I would provide evidence to back this up, but anyone who would dispute this claim clicked off the video when I compared The Phantom Menace to Citizen Kane. This is Queen Amidala. She's described as a woman who is extremely susceptible to sadness. That isn't foreshadowing, is it? This is her garbed Captain Panica. As you can tell, he is the handsome one. Amidala is being chased by Darth Maul, so they go to this desert planet to hide. Darth Maul can't follow them because he gets really bad sunburns. You may wonder why he can't buy sunscreen, but that provides evidence that you did not pay attention during all of that boring stuff about trade deals. In that scene, they mentioned a tariff on sunscreen, which is why he can't buy any. Here they meet Anakin, a kid who is Spellcheck's worst enemy. This robot, who was in an irrelevant scene earlier, gets into a gay relationship with Anakin's robot. This storyline was explored greater near the middle of Episode 2, during the part you slept through. In order to leave the planet, they need to buy a part from Watto here. Qui-Gon's mind control doesn't work, so they steal his sex tape and blackmail him. And no, you cannot have it. They take Anakin with him, but then Darth Maul attacks. Notice his hood. This gives more evidence to my sunburn theory. Then they kill Darth Maul with a sun lamp. Qui-Gon also dies. This death might be meaningful if he was at all relevant. Episode 2. The plot thickens. Someone is trying to kill Amidala. She's no longer the queen because someone staged a military coup, so she changed her name to Padme and moved to Coruscant. Instead of assuming that she's trying to be killed by the government that overthrew her, they send a Jedi to check in on her. Why? Naboo has a lot of oil, so the government wants to stay on their good side. Anakin is in anger management, and Obi-Wan is an anger management officer. As a team-building exercise, they decide to guard Padme's room while she's sleeping. This is a terrible idea because Anakin wants to fuck her. While jerking off in Padme's bedroom, Anakin sees bugs try to kill her. They follow the bugs to the source and find out that the assassin is dead. Anakin and Obi-Wan try to cover up the fact that they obviously killed the assassin by finding some random heroin needle on the ground and claim it as the murder weapon. Because he needs a suspect, Obi-Wan visits this diner owner, who, I'm not supposed to tell you this, but was in the Watto sex tape I mentioned earlier. It's easy to see why. He tells Obi-Wan to go jump in a lake, so he visits an ocean planet. Here he finds out that an old dead Jedi was in a pyramid scheme, and to find people to recruit into it, he cloned hundreds of thousands of people. Then he died, and no one knew what to do with them, so he created an army. Anakin and Padme are doing who cares. Obi-Wan gets captured by some assassin who claims to have hired and killed that assassin from earlier.
I can't believe the guy who hired that assassin also killed her.
Oh wait, I don't. Anakin and Padme come to save Obi-Wan. They get captured. They're about to be executed by three animals, named the Ruthakhadu and Todd. Obi-Wan kills that assassin so that he can't testify in court. It turns out that old white guy has pirated Taylor Swift CDs, so they run after him. This old guy, named Rob, owns a construction company in Ohio, but he was tempted by the power and became a Sith Lord. He cuts off Anakin's hand. George Lucas finds this sexually fulfilling, so he made sure to cut off as many hands as he could in future movies. Rumor has it that he keeps all the fake hands used as props in his basement. Anakin and Padme get married in a double wedding with C-3PO and R2-D2, because apparently that shit got serious in those scenes where Anakin advocated dictatorship and bitched about sand. Episode 3, The Angry Boy. Anakin and Obi-Wan are raiding a ship to rescue the president. He's being held captive by Rob. Rob surrenders. I got a wife and four kids in a suburb of Columbus, don't kill me. But Anakin does anyway, because the Jedi Order is a cult, not a military organization, so they are exempt from the Geneva Convention. Anakin returns to Coruscant to find that Padme is pregnant. Anakin is being rejected for promotion in the Jedi Order, so, in a fit of rage, violently leaves a mean Yelp review for the Jimmy John's franchise that is a money laundering front for the Jedi. Obi-Wan goes to kill some robot because his software contains a porn firewall. Obi-Wan wanted to watch that Watto sex tape, so he needed to kill the robot. Meanwhile, Anakin got appointed to be the president's bodyguard. The president is an evangelical plagueite, which is a religion that follows Darth Plagueis the Wise. He tries too hard to push his religion onto Anakin, so Anakin tries to drown him out by telling him about his own problems. The president suggests that Anakin goes on Mori Povich. Anakin finds out he is the father, so he goes berserk and kills a bunch of children. The president takes advantage of this to stage a coup and establish a theocracy. With his newfound power, he kills all the Jedi because they are religious rivals. What is Obi-Wan doing? You are powerless, Grievous! I changed the Wi-Fi password. This powers him off because he is one of those apps that acts like it needs an internet connection when it really doesn't, so they can run ads. The Pyramid Scheme army tries to kill Obi-Wan, but he survives because he agrees to join the Pyramid Scheme. Yoda does the exactly same thing. Obi-Wan goes to stop Anakin from killing people, so he sneaks on Padme's ship. She catches him popping bubble wrap in the closet he hid in. Obi-Wan gets kicked off the ship, and he fights Anakin. Obi-Wan wins. He has the high ground, which any military strategist can tell you is a means to immediately surrender. Anakin does, and gets brought to The Hague to be tried for his war crimes, but escapes in transit, and to mask his identity, wears a black suit. It's common misconception that he needs it to live, but he actually just wears it to look edgy. He gets a job for the president, and becomes the head of the military. Padme has two kids, but dies in childbirth. Canonically, she dies of sadness, but what the fuck, no, kill her from literally anything else. Episode 4, The Quest for the Watto Sex Tape. This is Luke. He's a normal teenager. An actual normal teenager, not one of those blue-haired Japanese teenagers that claim to be normal in an anime. R2-D2 and C-3PO are for sale because Padme's daughter needed the money. Luke's family farms water but is able to afford two robots. That doesn't seem to add up. What if this whole water farm is just a money laundering scheme? So the feds show up and Luke's aunt and uncle get sentenced to 184 years for possession of cocaine and money laundering. They were repeat offenders. Luke finds out that R2-D2 has a message in its disk drive. It's the Watto sex tape. There's also a message from Padme's daughter, who is somehow still a princess, even though her mother was overthrown in a military coup. And she's a princess of a different planet? Is this the space Habsburgs? She got kidnapped by Edgelord Anakin and needs help. So Luke goes through his aunt and uncle's contacts from their drug business and finds Han Solo, a pilot. Luke trades the Watto sex tape for his services. His protege, Chewbacca, did 9 years for battery and then got sent to anger management for his job in HR. He then got fired from that job because he could only speak in screams. Luke finds some dude named Ben, he's a Jedi or something, who cares. Then they go to some Mink Benno ball in space that's rumored to be able to destroy a planet. Then it destroys a planet. You see, Rob's pirated Taylor Swift CDs also had plans for Giant Death Base. The Jedi never noticed because the Jedi's IT department was just one guy named Harold who didn't know how to open a RAR file. Then some spy finds out that they have the Watto sex tape, so he steals it and gets Luke and Han arrested for prostitution. They didn't commit that crime, but it was a dictatorship, so who cares? They're brought to trial and find out that Watto is the judge. Watto sentences them to the trash compactor along with that bitch with the cinnamon roll hair. He confiscated that Watto sex tape, but luckily it was on a USB shaped like a Kit Kat. What Watto had was just a regular Kit Kat. They escaped by bribing the guard with the Watto sex tape. This was also just a Kit Kat. Because Harold was converted to a Plagueite, he decided to become a IT guy for the Empire. He decided it would be easier to put the plans and the Watto sex tape on the same USB. Somehow, Harold managed to actually put the plans on the Kit Kat, so the C-3PO had to eat it to get the plans. Then, so everyone could escape, Ben sacrifices himself. This death proves anyone can be killed off in Star Wars. I don't like this. What if they kill the gonk droid? Then Luke blows up the big metal spaceball. On Han's ship, Ben left a note that says, "I'm actually Obi-Wan, motherfucker." And this plot twist was the biggest plot twist in Star Wars. No one saw it coming. Episode 5, Luke's Daddy Issues. Everyone is on some ice planet. The Empire's closing in on said planet. How do we get here? Why is everyone so disjointed? It all started on Halloween when Han accidentally handed out the Watto sex tape to the children. When the Empire found out about this, they killed thousands of children. This spread fear in the galaxy. Han and Leia are making out. Luke goes to Yoda's planet. He claims to be the dictator. Of whom? There is nothing on this planet except a swamp. Yoda trains Luke to recruit 3 friends. Because he joined the Pyramid Scheme, he needs to recruit 3 people. He hasn't talked to anyone in 17 years. After this training, Luke needs to meet up with his friends to recruit 3 of them. Leia, Han, and Chewbacca are being chased to some sky planet. A planet that needs to use power to be suspended in the sky sounds like a place where the economy would be shit. The reason it isn't is because the surface of the planet contains addictive substances. Edgelord Anakin hired these bounty hunters, or as I call them, the Karens Galactic Brigade, or KGB, to put Han in a rock because he was vaccinated. Everyone around thinks they are under the influence of the surface drugs, but this actually happened. Luke and Anakin fight. Anakin corners Luke and delivers the famous line, "Luke, I am Daddy, Uwu. I went on Maury Povich in the 90s to confirm this." Luke doesn't believe this because his aunt and uncle taught him not to trust government officials. Anakin cuts off Luke's hand to fulfill George Lucas's desires. Episode 6, The Yub-Nub Intensifies. Leia goes to rescue Block Han from the sentient squirt of ketchup. She gets captured and forced into sexual servitude. This scene often gets demonetized, which is why there's a censor blur. I like money. Luke shows up to save her. This couldn't possibly be a trap. Oh fuck, it was a trap. They're about to be executed by this monster. This is a common tradition in the Star Wars universe. No one cares that it's a war crime. Then UN peacekeeping forces show up, so everyone has to be let go. Everyone goes to some forest planet so they can destroy the big metal ball too, Electric Boogaloo. This place is called Kong Gia Vietnam. Why is it called that? Because it means Space Vietnam in Vietnamese. It's inhabited by these small merchandise monsters. They used to be human, but they were all furries and eventually evolved into those. Luke travels to the Space Ball 2 to face the Dictator. Edgelord Anakin tries to convert Luke to be a Plagueite. He fails. The President tries to kill him. He fails. After he failed, he tells Luke that it isn't fair that Luke is super powerful. To this, Luke responds with, "Okay, Boomer." This defeats the President. Luke escapes, and then the Space Ball explodes. Anakin dies. The only loose end left is where the Watto sex tape is. Turns out Steve has it. He bought it from his friend who stole it from their kid who traded it for their pudding at lunch. Luke takes the Watto sex tape and makes a map of where he's hiding, then puts them into R2-D2 and shuts him off. He leaves and then Star Wars ends. There are no more Star Wars movies. I'm solo, I'm Han Solo, I'm Han Solo, I'm Han Solo, solo. Picking up my blaster, putting it on my sign. I'm jumping in my Falcon, putting it on my sign. I'm solo, I'm Han Solo, I'm Han Solo, I'm Han Solo.